Good afternoon. The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection. And our time for reflection leader today is Reverend Andrew Agnew, pastor, the Living Room Church.
Presiding officer, members of the Scottish Parliament, thank you so much for this invitation to address you during your time for reflection. You stand or sit at the beginning of another important year of work. Similarly, at the Living Room Church in Wallyford, where I'm the minister, and Wallyford is a small town on the edge of Musselburgh, we also stand at the beginning of another important year of work. There are times like this when we reclarify our aims, we motivate our people, we prepare for many challenges that lie in the year ahead of us. And I want to choose three biblical commands that guide me as I co-lead our church in the hope that they may inspire you too. Number one, seek the welfare of the city. Those words were spoken to a minority group in Persia who were viewed as strange. Those who followed the God of Israel were told to work for the good of the country that they were in. It wasn't their ultimate home, but they were to live and to settle and especially to pray for the good of their host country. Thanks to the amazing parliamentary prayer group, we in our church are learning to do that regularly, to pray for you in your work, especially as you endeavor to help this country after years of trauma. Number two, put on the armor of God. Spoken to different minority group in the city of Ephesus in what is modern-day Turkey, the Christians who lived there had their critics and they had their enemies. Life then, as now, was within a cosmopolitan society with differing values and differing beliefs. This was a call to take truth, faith, and the good news of Jesus as Lord and Savior, crucified, buried, and resurrected for our forgiveness. We are teaching our church dependence on Jesus as we face the challenges ahead. And lastly, fix your eyes on Jesus. Spoken to another different minority group of Christians from Jewish backgrounds facing imprisonment because of their association with Jesus, they were given examples of people in the Bible who experienced hardship yet trusted God, and then helped to focus on the supreme example of Jesus, who gave his very life for our salvation, to give them strength to stay the course, come what may. Members of this Parliament, we in Wallyford will be praying for you, joining our sisters and our brothers here from Parliamentary Prayer Scotland and many other churches, praying for wisdom, for truth, courage, protection, guidance, strength, blessing, and to do what is right in the year ahead. May God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend. Thank you very much.